Hey lab peeps, welcome to the Lab Tech Report, a bi-weekly video series where we dive into the world of recent laboratory regulations, discoveries, and news. Join me on this week's journey through time and space. Or just through some interesting topics. Roll that intro. Canadian company prepares to use biometric facial recognition for positive patient identification with an in-home prescription drug dispensing device. Positive patient identification is a common challenge among medical laboratories. A Canadian company is working on bringing a biometric facial recognition scanner to the market, which can help positively identify patients. These kinds of biometric scanners can more reliably identify patients and index records rather than using social security numbers or birth dates. This could mean more unique patient identifiers on specimens as they move through the lab, hopefully increasing safety and security. Currently, the most common ways to identify an infection are through rapid strips or microbiology, both of which can take time and require more specified training and education. A group of biochemists have created molecules which bind to leukocyte enzymes and produce an electrical current, which is identified by a computer. The results can not only show if there is an infection, but also how severe it is, speeding up diagnosis and treatment. There's a new microscope which has the ability to image living tissue in real time and in molecular detail without the use of any dyes or chemicals. In a study of mammary tumors in rats, researchers were able to identify variances in metabolism and morphology which indicated tumor cells. They also saw communication between the tumor cells and the surrounding cells in the form of vesicles. Demonstrating this versatility has shown how microscopes like this can change the way we diagnose and treat in the future. Sources for all of today's topics linked in the description below. That's it for today's report. Not a lot to choose from this week. Let us know in the comments below what your thoughts were on the articles we covered today. Did we miss something that was cool or interesting that may have affected your lab this week? Check back here every other Thursday for more episodes. Follow our Facebook page for more updates. Also, we are on IGTV now. You know, the Instagram vertical thing. Go follow us there for bite-sized breakdowns of the happenings in the lab world. Link in the description below. That being said, I hope you all have a fantastic week, and I'll see you in the next one.